now to education. We've all been to school, university, but now a new phenomenon which is happening is that of homeschooling. I have four children sat at the back there. None of them have ever been to school in their lives. They speak two languages fluently, and they're about to start to learn Mandarin Chinese. So watch that space. Now, the school system is interesting. But my question is, are they telling us the truth? Now, let's think of the pyramids in Egypt, for example. Now, who actually built those pyramids? When I was studying ancient Egyptians in school the very first time, I think I was about 9, 10 years old, I thought, well, how did these people carry those very heavy bricks and build this thing? And then I looked more into it as I got older and read more into it. And I thought, well, did these Egyptians really build the pyramids? Now, I'm not telling you they didn't, but I'm asking the question, and I leave it up to you to go and find the answer. Did the Egyptians really build the pyramids? What about JFK, famous president of the United States in the 1960s, got shot? Okay, they said he was assassinated by this person that shot him, and then they discovered he had bullets in the back of his head as well. So my question is, who really shot John Kennedy? Or maybe, should I ask the question, why did they shoot him? What's the real reason why? Next thing, man on the moon. Man landed on the moon the very first time in 1969. I was 2 months old when man landed on the moon. 12 men have walked on the moon, according to history. My question is, with all the technological advances we've had in the last 45 years, why is it that we haven't been back? I think there's probably two reasons. One, there's probably somebody else on there, from somewhere else. Or the second possibility could be that we actually never went. Now, whether we went to the moon or not, I'm not saying we didn't go, I'm not saying we went, but the question is, did we really go? Next question, September the 11th. You may have heard of this. Some of you may have been around when that happened. I remember that day I was due to start a new job with an airline in Manchester, flying Boeing 737s, starting in October, and then this happened, and it got delayed till February. So I remember what happened that day. And then I started to investigate. And I asked many questions, and I watched many documentaries and spoke to many people. And it didn't go the way they tell you it went. It went very differently. And the reasons are very interesting. There's always a geopolitical situation behind all these things. So geopolitics is something that we really need to study. Don't believe what the TV tells you. Don't believe what the news people tell you. Always question. Always question. And today we've got Google, we've got the internet, so we can go on there and we can find information. But beware, because there's a lot of rubbish on there as well. But you've got to have an inquisitive mind. And this is one of the criticisms I have towards the standard schooling system. They teach you to read from a book, and then they ask you questions from the book. What if the answers aren't in the book? What if the information that I want is not in the book? Then what happens? So the most important thing, two important things that you need to learn. Number one is how to study and how to absorb information quickly. And the second thing is to be creative. Because when you get involved in business, things aren't going to go according to the book. Things are going to go differently. Things are going to happen that you didn't expect, and now you've got to think on your feet. And when you go out there with a business idea and you pitch it to investors or come to people like me that maybe has money to invest, I won't be looking at the business as much as I'll be looking at you. I want to find out why you developed this, who you are, what makes you tick, what your ideas are for the future, what your goals are. They invest more in the person than in the project. So bear that one in mind. And again, the ability to think on your feet and the ability to be creative are the two most important things and the two traits that successful entrepreneurs have compared to those that are unsuccessful. Now bear in mind, not everybody succeeds every time. I've had my failures, I've had my string of failures, but when you do fail at something, you've got to ask yourself the question, what did I learn? And if you learn something from it, and I guarantee if you ask yourself that question, there'll be something that you would have picked up, something that you would have learned, and then you take that positive into the future. And you go on to the next venture, but you don't stop.